Hello students, so in this class we will discuss few MCQ from this chapter electromagnetic induction. Okay, so this is Shobhik Das and I have come here to discuss few MCQ with all of you on this chapter electromagnetic induction. So our first question is this is our first question and this is your timer. I am just starting your timer. Yes, so tell the correct option, read the question first of all. Read the question, yes, and your timer is going on. And this, okay, a square shaped coil of size 20 centimeter, number of turns 1000, placed perpendicular to the magnetic flux lines, which is changing at rate 1 tesla per second emf induced. Okay, just 1 second and time's up. So let's see students, first of all the correct option is 40 volt. Yes, correct option is 40 volt. So let's see the explanation EMF. First of all, we know flux equal to B dot A. Okay, B dot A, so B A cos theta, when flux changes then EMF will come in picture. Okay, now theta is what? Theta is the angle between magnetic field vector and area vector. Okay, now magnetic flux lines are perpendicular to the square shaped coil. Okay, this is a square shaped coil. Okay, magnetic field lines are perpendicular, means suppose perpendicularly inward, cross represents perpendicularly inward. Now for this loop, what will be the area direction? The area vector becomes perpendicular to the loop means perpendicular to this board. Okay, that means we can consider that magnetic field B vector, which are going inside, and area vector also perpendicular to this plane. So we can consider that B parallel to A. Okay, B parallel to A means 0 degree. Okay, so here B A cos theta means simply we will get B A. Now EMF equal to d phi dt. So here which quantity is changing? B is changing at rate 1 tesla per second. So we will take A dB dt. Okay, so area is given how much? 20 centimeter is the side. So 20 by 100 square. Okay, side square into magnetic field is changing, dB dt is 1. And another term is given, that is number of turns. Okay, number of turns also you can put here N. Okay, N. Okay, here also N means 1000. Okay, so how much? 2 1, so 2 by 10 square means 4 by 100 into 1000, that means 40 volt. Okay, 4 by 100 into 1000 means 40 volt. So in the formula of phi, N will also come, number of turns will also come. Okay, fine. Our next question. Yes, so this is your second question and your timer started. Yes, tell, if N is the number of turns in a coil, the value of self inductance varies as: option A, N to the power minus 2, option B, N to the power 0, option C, N to the power 1, yeah, option D, N square. So your time 10 second, 9 second. Yes, tell the answer. Tick tock, time is ending, and time is finished. So first of all, let's see the correct answer. Correct answer is D. D is the correct answer here. Okay, self inductance of a coil ka ek formula hai, L equal to mu 0 N square A by L. Okay, what is mu 0? Mu 0 is free space permeability. Okay, free space permeability. Okay, if any other material is there, then mu or relative permeability will come in picture. N is number of turns, A is area of the loop. Okay, solenoid will look like this. So area of each loop, okay, this loop area, and L is length of the solenoid. Okay, so it depends on N square. Fine. Let's see the next question. Question number 3 is this, and your timer started. Yes, tell the correct option. Yes, A coil of resistance 7 ohm, inductance 5 Henry is connected to 70 volt battery. Then the energy stored in the magnetic field of the coil is, okay? Magnetic field of the coil is 500 joule, 500 arc, 250 joule, here 250 arc. Your time 5 second, 4 second, 3 second, 2 second and time's up. So let's see first of all the correct answer. Correct answer will be C 250 joule. Okay, C 250 joule. How? So this is the inductor. Okay, this is the inductor connected to 70 volt battery. 70 volt. Okay. Now this coil has some resistance also, 7 ohm, and its inductance is 5 Henry. Okay. Now when we know the resistance, we can find the current. Right, we can find the current. What about the current? Current will be V by R, that means 70 by 7, so 10 ampere is the current. Okay, now as current is flowing through this coil, magnetic field will generate along the axis, and in that magnetic field region, magnetic field energy or magnetic energy will be stored. Okay, and the formula of magnetic energy formula is half L I square. So it will be half L means 5, I square means 10 square means 100. 2 and 100 will get cancelled out. Here you will get 50 into 5 is 25, 250 joule. So correct answer is 250 joule. Okay, going to next question number 4, and your timer started. Yes, tell the correct option. Question number 4. When the current in a coil changes from 2 ampere to 4 ampere in 0.05 second. Okay. 2 ampere to 4 ampere in 0.05 second. EMF 8 volt is induced in the coil. You have to find coefficient of self-inductance. Very easy question. Direct formula based question. Time 5 second, 4 second, 3 second, 2 second, 1 second and 0 second. So correct option ko pehle dekh lete hai. Correct option will be A, 0.2 Henry. We have to find L, right? We have to find L. Okay. So here EMF is given. So EMF, we'll use the formula of EMF. E equal to L delta I by delta T. Okay, we'll not use sign because all the values are given only. So here it is 8 equal to L into delta I, how much? 2 to 4, that means 4 minus 2 by time required 0.05. okay, so L will be 8 into 0.05 by 4 minus 2 is 2. So 2 4s are 8, 4 5s are 20, so 0.20 Henry. okay, so correct answer is option A. So next question students. Yes, next question is question number 5. Very easy question, theory based question, and this is the last question for today. Okay, this is the last question for today. The ratio of secondary to primary turns in a transformer is 3:3:2 and the output power is P, neglecting all the power losses, the input power. Okay, transformer ratio of primary and secondary turns are given and output power is given. Yes, time 4 second, 3 second, 2 second and time's up. So let's see, very easy question, answer will be P. Okay, so here turns ratios are given. In S to N primary is given 3:2. Okay, but it has no function here because when we are neglecting all power losses means the transformer is ideal transformer. And in ideal transformer, what happens? Total output power equal to input power. There is no loss in power. Okay, output power equal to input power. Now output power is P given. So input power will be also P. Okay, output power equal to input power, because here it is given neglecting all power losses. Okay, so correct answer will be this B. Okay, that means output power is P, input power will also be P. Okay, so these are few questions for today from the chapter electromagnetic induction. Okay, so I hope you all have enjoyed. So this is Souvik Das signing off. Thank you everyone.